Hello, everybody. What the flick? We are here talking about the last episode of the first season of The Strain. Mm-hmm. I'm William Bibbiani.
Ryan Turek, managing editor of Shockley Drop.
Good plug. Let's throw to a clip.
Boys have hunted beside their fathers. This is no different.
Dad!
This is very different.
Did you think you had been turned?
He gave me health, but not immortality.
Coven.
The master must be around here somewhere.
Don't miss the thrilling season finale.
In the name of all that is holy!
The Strain.
Our producers just referred to this as the Resident Evil episode. And it is! This episode just turns straight up into a video game by the end. Just going level to level from the underground to the dance floor, killing off vampires. Yeah. To the boss fight where you have to shoot out the windows. Uh-huh. Like, oh my God, you can manipulate the environment in this show.
Yeah.
It's so great.
Yeah.
Good ending.
A great ending. I mean, Alonzo, who's not here with us this week for the finale, we were speculating how this would end. And I said, well, I don't know if they can have another showdown with the Master since they had already had a false showdown. Mm-hmm. But this one delivered on all levels for me. I mean, I had a great time with it. I love the show. But I also kind of cringe every time I see the usual vampire tropes. So when I see the shooting out of the windows, I'm thinking like, Fright Night, From Dusk Till Dawn. Like my nerd brain is going, but still.
I went Conan the Destroyer, but okay.
Wow.
I like that movie.
So it was just interesting that they play on those tropes. I like that Eldritch Palmer. He's now become this kind of Renfield type where the master is now dangling power in front of his face.
I like his little bit where he's like, when do I get the and then I was like, oh yeah, you didn't read the contract.
We didn't give you that worm.
Yeah.
I like that was his terminology. We didn't give you the worm.
Right, which like, I didn't know there was other stuff they could give you. That's actually a new wrinkle.
Yeah.
That you can actually like, there's
other
more
goo.
To. Well, and this is actually like, they're really starting to talk about other elements of the mythos that we haven't seen before.
Yeah.
We have the SWAT vampires are now here, and we see that there are several other masters who apparently are not down with what the master is taking over New York is doing.
Right, there's some kind of like peace treaty that's broken, and I think we're gonna get into that in season two.
I would hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they can't really do much, but they do have a very long extended middle finger. Did you notice that? They had like a weird thing, but that was all cool.
That was all really cool. And I liked that, because again, we did have the false showdown with the master. Then we have a showdown with the master and it ends in a way that like, oh, he can go out in the day?
Yeah.
That's doesn't seem good. And it really just, because Satrakian has been our guru.
Yeah, he's been our know-it-all.
He's been our sage. Yeah. We trust every single thing he says. And now we learn that he didn't know shit. And that's
he knows
a really
shit,
fun
but he's just, but he doesn't know it all. You know? And we're just kind of like, now there's a sense of unease because if we can't put our trust in him, who are we going to put our trust in? Where's our leader now? And F is going to have to step up to the plate for that.
But now he's an alcoholic again.
Yes. Cool.
Yeah. Like, fine.
More inner demons.
Right. Instead of just the outer demons we've been focusing on this whole time. Yeah. They kind of forgot to mention the whole alcoholism angle for many episodes.
And they downplayed the moment when he did drink. I think. I mean, like, they could have been like, Nora could have been like, "Oh my gosh, F, don't do that."
She says, "Don't."
No,
but I think
I
think everyone's at the point where it's like, "Yeah, at this point, who gives a shit, man? Like, you might as well." I was a little disappointed by how minimal the confrontation with his wife was.
Yeah.
Because, again, that's another one they set up. She's been turned into a vampire. Apparently she's going to be one of the master's favorites or something.
Right.
They really set that up.
They're going to use her as bait more and more often, I guess.
Sure, so, but like, what did we accomplish from this minimal showdown at the end? It's like the kid now knows his mom was a vampire and he's messed up. Granted, but you could have done that and had, I don't know, more of like an interaction between F and his wife, ex-wife, or you could have had more fight.
Could have happened in the theater. You know, they did have that false moment where, you know, the kid and F both killed the woman that they thought was the wife. But you're right, it was kind of a throwaway encounter.
I think they were trying to show to both of those characters that there's no going back.
Yeah, it just kind of felt like a reminder.
Yeah.
I do like the moment between F and his son teaching him how to kill.
Yeah.
That's such a fantastic moment. And he really sold it too. That was a really great moment.
That's the stuff I like about this kind of post-apocalyptic stories when like, you know, all of the, or I guess mid-apocalyptic stories where we're at now, but it's those moments where you realize that the things that were appropriate and that kept you alive and flourishing in the pre-apocalyptic world no longer apply, and now I need to teach my son the best place to stab someone.
Yeah.
And that was a good moment. They treated it with seriousness, like this simply has to happen, but there was a certain melancholy to it. Yeah. And that was very, very, exactly. very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was a couple other moments I liked. I liked that Bolivar came back, the rocker. Except now
he's missing. Before I was confused.
No, he just disappeared.
Yeah, okay.
He disappeared and he came back and he disappears and he comes back.
I like that he's never taken off his wig.
He never takes off his wig. He's lost his member in the early on in the season. Now he's lost his tongue as well because Nora cut it off or someone cut it off. So
like
now he's just
like
completely demasculated through the entire thing, all through season two. It should just be about him trying to find his manhood again. And then I especially like too just the one moment with the rat catcher, always forgetting his name.
Vasily
and F, standing outside the theater and going, inside, that's where the master rests. It's such a great I Am Legend type moment, you know? I like that kind of
thing. Vasily is such a great character.
He was someone that we were kind of early on going, we don't know about this guy. He might be a little over the top.
But the show got over the top to match him. He started out over the top, and the show just sort of caught up.
Yeah.
And he's so... I'm worried he's going to be like, who's that one character everyone loves on Walking Dead? Daryl?
Daryl.
Daryl is almost
he's
a little...
He's going to be the heartthrob?
He's going to be the hunky, hunky heartthrob. Oh, dude, I would throw myself all over
Ladies,
that.
Ladies, find yourself a rat catcher.
But he's got the cool accent. He's badass, capable in a fight. But what I like about him is that in addition to just being a badass, a fighter, whatever, he's actually smart. And I really appreciate that the show has a sense of New York history and that the way it's impacting everything.
And he's bringing
to
a
this
lot
day.
Of that to the table.
It just really makes the show seem smarter than it actually is.
Yeah.
Because ultimately what this is just a fun ride and I've really enjoyed this whole season. What about you?
I think it's been great. I think, like any first season, there's a lot of ups and downs.
Yeah.
But this one has been consistently entertaining all the way through and I think it definitely found its upswing in the latter half. So,
what are your hopes and concerns for season two?
Season two, open up the canvas, man. I mean, like they gave us that one final shot in this season of New York City, fires burning everywhere.
That was
a gorgeous shot. It was the first time we were, again, and this is the one nitpicky thing I have with the entire season, is pull back that camera. Let's see New York City as it is, thrown into chaos. Even when F and Vasily were like hanging out in the alleyway and we still hear car crashes, we still hear people screaming, all this other stuff happening, I want to see that. So my hope is that they pull back and open up the canvas a little bit so we could see all the craziness going on. However, I suspect they're going to jump forward in time for season two.
How far do you think?
Just a couple months.
Yeah. I think that's kind of what we need. I think we need to have like a new status quo and really start treating this as like, even if it's just New York, even if they do kind of manage to keep the vampirism at bay, just it's like Escape from Vampire New York would be a really, really great concept.
Yeah, well, that's a great idea.
It is a great idea.
I think we might have something with F. F tackled the vampire, the master, out into daylight. He didn't get scratched, a worm didn't jump ship into
That happens in every horror movie. Every zombie movie, someone cuts off a zombie head, gets splashed with their blood, and I'm just like, get the disinfectant wipes. It's not a good thing.
That doesn't work.
Something oughta. Anyway, you have to just sort of accept that. Yeah. There should be worms flying all over these people. And on that note, thank you for watching The Strain with us. We'll be back next season.
Bye.